السلام عليكم. في المحاضرة الماضية كنا في chapter 4 and we are now we are trying to understand the enhanced entity relation diagram. في المحاضرة الماضية أخذنا اللي هو ال concept of super class and subclasses and how طبعاً we used two ways to generate these subclasses out or derive these subclasses out of the superclass. The first we method called specialization. We start with an entity and then we dependent on a factor or in a characteristic, we start deriving the subclasses. And this procedure called specialization. And we took another procedure which is called generalization, which is we start with the subclasses or entities in your diagram. We collect the common factors to generate or to construct the super class for these subclasses. And we took this example for the car and the truck. We have attributes here, vehicle ID, license plate number, price, license plate number, and vehicle ID. So we have common factors between these two entities. So we construct here a super class called vehicle, and we add these three attributes to the super class. So we get enhanced ER diagram by using generalization in this way. Okay. So we generalized the subclasses or the entities car and truck to a super class vehicle. Today we will take some constraints on the procedure of or the process of specialization and generalization. First constraint is membership constraints. The membership constraints, we have to understand what we mean by membership. Membership, it's the instances which belongs to which entity type. So we have entity type and we have entities or instances. So instances, for example, if we are talking about a class or an entity type employee, the entities can be Ahmed, Ali, Hussein, or whatever. This is what we call entities or we call instances of the entity type. For membership, Ahmed is a member of the entity employee. Ali is a member of the entity employee. This is what we mean by the membership of the membership in general. Constraints is conditions on the membership. There is sometimes dependent on the requirements or scenarios of the business rules of the new world, you will come up with the membership constraints. So you have to express them or تعبر عنهم في ال ER diagram. Okay. The first thing is condition defined. The condition defined means that it's constraint on the membership as we said before. So it's we evaluate or we use it in the specialization. Remember specialization, we generate or derive the subclasses from a superclass or from entity type. From entity type, we generate subclasses or subentities. So dependent على condition defined, we call this type of condition defined, we can call it it should explicit condition or predicate. So the subclasses in the specialization process should follow an attribute type or attribute some type of attribute. The specialization is called attribute defined. So the same thing, when we say condition defined, it should satisfy explicit condition or predicate, and this is dependent on attribute which we called defining attribute, and this process called attribute defined specialization. Okay, then the attribute we consider or نعتمد عليه to derive subclasses, we call it defining attribute. Defining attribute. Of course, this is only in specialization. For example, when you come to the employee, you will find a lot of attributes. You will find the name, you will find the social security number, you will find a lot of all these things, all the attributes, and one of them is اللي هو الجوب تايب. فالجوب تايب اتريبيوت وي كان يوز ات از ا ديفايننج اتريبيوت فور سبيشاليزيشن تو ديرايف ذا سب كلاسز اور ذا سيت اوف سب كلاسز سيكيرتري والتكنيشن والانجينير. فالكونديشن ديفايند ميكس يو ثينك اباوت وان اتريبيوت ذات كان ديرايف مور ذان وان انتيتي تايب subclasses from a superclass in the specialization process. That we what we call condition defined. Dependent على the defining attribute for the specialization to generate subclasses from a superclass اللي هي الامبلوي. Okay. So this is an enhanced ER diagram or EER اللي هي عندي الامبلوي. You have a lot of attributes of the employee, but when you come to the job type, you can consider this as a defining attribute, because the job type it can be secretary, then we can derive a class secretary. The job type can be technician, then we derive a technician entity. The job type can be engineer, then we will have the ability to derive an engineer man اللي هي الامبلويي. All these became subclasses or sub-entities from the employee, اللي هو superclass, dependent على the defining attribute, اللي هو job type. Remember, إنه relationship between the superclass and subclasses is a. فال secretary is an employee, وال technician is an employee, وال engineer is an employee, and so okay. Remember, in all these subclasses will inherit all the attributes here, including their specific attributes as we see in the EER. Okay, the second thing, you don't have a condition, you don't have attribute, defining attribute to generate your subclasses, then it depends maybe in the requirements as we said before, in the business rules of your system. For example, you don't have a condition defined, you will have a user defined. The user defined, what we mean by the user, it's the person who will use this database, who is the person who's you are doing this this database for, who's managing all this process. So he will tell you that, for example, that he has three types of employees, for example, or three teams of employees. Team Salt team, Herbit team, and for example, Karak team. So dependent on user as he likes, the one who wants you to make this database, he can define the subclasses according to his requirement or to his business rules. So for example, in this case, we call it a user defined. For example, in our university, we can, for example, for the purposes of the system, we have student entity, but the user defined, okay, I want in the registration for Qulub Tasjil, for example, he wants to have some classification for the students. Yes, student, but there is a graduate student, there is undergraduate student, there is senior students, there is MS or master students, and so on. Okay, but this is what we call as user defined. Belonging constraint. Belonging constraints, which entity? Remember, entity type, it will include entities or instances. So which entity or instance belongs to which entity type? This is what we call belonging constraints. Okay. So the first constraint is a disjoint constraint. What we mean by disjoint constraint? A disjoint constraint, this means that the entity can belong only to one subclass. So you have your instances, your entities, they can belong to one subclass only. If they belong, for example, in the previous example, if it's a secretary, the entity or the instance, then it can't be engineer or technician. So it belongs only, all the entities belongs can can belong to only one subclass. This is what we call disjoint. In disjoint, how we express it in our ER diagram, we put disjoint. So if we consider or look at this, اللي هو, at this diagram, the ER, we see that we have vehicle, we have car, we have truck, and we have disjoint is written beside the is a relationship beside the triangle. What we mean by this? This means if you have any entity belongs to car, it can't belong to truck. If you have any entity belong or instance belongs to truck, it can't belong to a car at the same time in this EER. And this is what we call disjoint, okay? And which is common sense, because if you have, for example, Mercedes, so it belongs to car. If you have, for example, whatever taxi, it belongs to car. It can't be truck, so it only belongs to or can be included in the car here subclass. Okay, so reversing the disjoint, we have an overlapping constraint. So it's understood the reverse is or the opposite of a disjoint is the same entity may be a member of more than one subclass. So it can be, it can belongs to more than a subclass. What we mean by lower level entity is mean subclasses overlap is the default case. So the default, we don't need to write anything. So if we don't write anything, if we didn't write disjoint, then they are overlapping. So the default is overlapping. Overlapping means, or let's explain it using this EER here. The student entity, this student entity type, it has instances. The instances can belong to student and can belong to employee at the same time. So you will have here some student who is working at the same time. He is employee in the company and in the university, for example. He is employee in our university and he is studying master or PhD at the same time. So the instance belongs to employee and belongs to student at the same time. So they are overlapping. This is why we didn't write anything, because it's default. So if you don't find the word disjoint, this means they are overlapping. Overlapping means any entity or instance can belong to more than one subclass. Completeness constraint. What do you mean by completeness constraint? Completeness satisfies, is it the complete all the instances of the superclass should be involved in subclasses, or some of them don't belong to any of this of the superclass. We have two types. We have total. A total, of course, all entities in the superclass should belong to one or more subclasses. So you don't find an entity or instance the superclass doesn't belong to any subclass. This is why we call it total. The total entities in the superclass belong to some type of one or more subclasses. This is what we call by completeness constraint total. In partial, not all entities in the superclass belong to one or more subclasses. You will find some entity or instance with superclass, not engineer, not secretary, not technician. So there exists some entities or instances with superclass don't belong to any of the subclasses. That's what we call it partial constraint, field completeness constraints. Of course, if you are doing generalization, it must be total, because how we create the generalization, how we create the superclass from the subclasses. This means the superclass instances all came from subclasses. So when you use generalization, it must be total. Okay, partial generalization is the default. shown in the ER diagram by a single line. طبعاً في التوتال we have we put double line between the triangle and the superclass. If we use a single line between is a relation and the superclass, so it's partial. So as we said, there exists some entities don't belong to the subclasses. Hence, في النتيجة, we will have all these terms or concepts, and you need to think about them. Disjoint total, this means the instance or the entity can belong only to one subclass. And total means that all the entities or instances الموجودين في superclass must belong to one subclass only. Okay, disjoint partial, this means disjoint means an entity can belong only to one subclass, and not all entities in the superclass belongs to an entity in the subclass. Overlapping total, this means all the superclass entities belongs to more than one subclass entities. Overlapping partial, this means some of the instances in the superclass may belongs to more than one subclass. Okay, note generalization زي ما حكينا انه دائما ايش بيكون the is total. ليش total؟ لأنه أصلا هو is because إنه super class ما هي wasn't exist. احنا using generalization جمعنا كل ال instances to construct super class. So super class all instances super class هم جايين من sub classes لأنه في generalization. ف it must be total usually. Okay, an example of patient enhanced ER diagram schema. Okay, you need to think about all these things that we took in this chapter and come up with an EER diagram. Okay, so you need to understand each of these points. كل واحدة من هذول لازم تفهمها. So to think, is it subclass? Is it a usual relation? Is it a superclass? And so. So you need to think about it and to try to derive the EER diagram. For example, a patient is defined by a patient ID and admission date. So this is attributes for the patient. The patient recognizes entity type. A patient must be either an emergency patient or a resident patient. Here, maybe we can have a patient as a superclass. Emergency patient can be a subclass. Resident patient can be another subclass. We must record the check back date for emergency patient. So the subclass emergency patient should have a check back attribute. Only resident patient is assigned to one room. This means there is a relationship assigned to between resident patient between the room entity. Room entity has a unique number, the attributes, degree, and floor and number. For each room, there are a number of bits. So we have multi-valued attribute bits, each of which has a bit number, a specification.